Storytelling is a cornerstone of Somali culture. While there are many genres to Somali expression, like the gabay, epic poetry, the qasido, religious poems, hes, songs, today we are going to talk about folktales, also known as sheko hariruyin. Folktales are central to Somali people's lives. They can be told around the encampment fire, whispered to children at bedtime, or shared in a group of friends. Folktales are astonishingly well preserved in oral history, and certain stories have been passed on from generation to generation and in all the different regions inhabited by Somalis. In this video, we are going to talk about the fantastical creatures, animals, and heroes that constitute Somali lore. And in that sense, we have to highlight and celebrate the work of Ahmed Artenhenge, who investigated Somali lore in the late 80s and collected them in his book, Sheko Hariruyin Somaliyet. Much like the Brothers Grimm, who were collectors of popular tales and popularized stories like Cinderella or Snow White, Ahmed Artan interviewed Somali elders and collected their account. Let's start with animal tales. Animals have a large place in Somali folktales. Stories about them illustrate Somali people's connection to nature and their environment. Miga, the plains and shrublands, which are the traditional environment of pastoral people. Animal tales are used by Somalis to teach children about values, morals, and wisdom. In animal tales, animals represent people, and each animal possesses a defining human trait. The awo, the fox, is a cunning trickster who often takes advantage of other animals. One such simple-minded animal is warabe, the hyena, who often gets taken advantage of and fooled by the fox. Warabe the hyena is often the villain of the tale, but her malice is overcome by the resourcefulness and intelligence of the other animals. In the wide open plains of Somalia, the hyena is indeed the enemy of the Somalis' main riches, their livestock, and children are taught at a young age how to trick and defeat her. Other notable animals in Somali folktales are Bisid Yajir, the cat and the mouse, Lah Yuri, the sheep and the goat, Marudi Yadabagale, the elephant and the squirrel, Yahas, the crocodile, Libeh, the lion, and Din, the tortoise. A lot of Somali animal tales have similarities with Aesop's fables, like the boy who cried wolf, where a young shepherd repeatedly tricks people from his village into thinking a wolf is attacking their flock. In the tale Umar Iye Warabe, Umar and the hyena, Umar performs the same lies until nobody believes him and comes to his help when the hyena devours him. Some historians believe the famous Greek fabulist Aesop to be of Ethiopian origins, which could make sense since animal tales are widely shared on the African continent. Other fascinating heroes of Somali folktales are the fantastical creatures, like Degder the ogress and her daughter, Butsi. Folktales describe Degder as a very tall woman with an incredible force that was so fast she could outrun horses. Markay qof iryanisu sida dabaysha bayxiimin jirtay. She would sound like a fast wind when she was in pursuit of someone. Digeheeda midbaa sida eyga u dheereed. Sidaas ugeed baa loogu bixiyay naanaysta Degder. One of her ears was long like that of a dog, which earned her the nickname Degder. Degder was so cunning and deceiving that she would build the semblance of a town with several houses to trick passing travelers looking for water and a place to rest. They would stop in her pretend town where she would then capture and eat them. But in one of the tales, Degder is outsmarted by two children, Farido and her younger brother. Farido, whose name means the wise girl, is the elder of a family of four children. One day Farido takes her brothers and sisters to collect berries, and when she tries to make her way back to her family's homestead, she finds out that her family has already left the grounds. Farido then proceeds to find water and shelter for her little brothers and sisters, and ends up walking into Degder's pretend town. The children are captured by the ogress, but Farido manages to escape with one of her younger brother, and they rebuild their lives together, far from Degder's territory. Farido and Degder's tale is very similar to that of Hansel and Gretel, who find themselves lost in a forest and walk into the evil witch's lair, made of gingerbread and pastries. For Somali children, a town in the desert with the promise of refreshing cover from the scorching sun would have the allure of the delicious pastries that entice the German children, Hansel and Gretel. Somali folktales have been educating children on the dangers of the wide open plains and deserts. and how they should learn to rely on wisdom and resourcefulness to tame the hostile nature. It's a very common trope in fairy tales to represent nature's chaos and hostility to a very powerful, evil, feminine archetype like Dagder. Which is why when Dagder is defeated, the children sing, Dagder di matoi dulki nabade. Dagder is no more, the land is at peace. Nature's chaos and hostility is often contained and overcome by the ingenuity and wisdom of the old man's archetype, which we also find in Somali folktales. The Wadad, or Aday, often represents the sum of knowledge and wisdom passed on through the generations. Another very powerful female figure in Somali folktales is Queen Arawelo. While Dagder stories are believed to be entirely symbolical, there is not a complete consensus on whether or not Queen Arawelo ruled Somali territories. Some Somali places still bear names in reference to her, like a place named Jehi Arawelo, Arawelo's Valley, situated near the city of Ilayo in Somaliland. Ilayo is also believed to have been the place where Queen Arawelo would move her court in the winter seasons. In that town, there is a stone mound called Talotiriad, which is believed to be Arawelo's tomb. Whenever Somali men passed by that stone mound, they would throw several stones onto it with a curse upon Arawelo's name, while in contrast, Somali women would place green branches and fresh flowers as a sign of respect for the greatest woman ruler in Somali oral tradition. The story of Arawelo gives a very insightful look into the underlying tension that exists between men and women in Somali culture. While there is a clear division of tasks between men and women in the traditional Somali family, with men venturing outside the homestead to water camels and to partake in warfare, and women staying back to care for infants and household chores, in times of peace, the burden of running the household sometimes falls disproportionately on women, which leads the clever, fiery, and proud Arawelo to tell her husband, a woman could also do what a man does. Most of the men in the town council are old fools. Why not allow able women to take their places? Arawelo then proceeds to foment an insurrection of the women to overthrow the power of men, and she turns them into eunuchs. There is a striking resemblance between the story of Arawelo and her army of female warriors and that of the nomadic Amazons, whose name is believed to have been derived from the Iranian Amazana, meaning virility killing, and whose lands were believed to be at the rim of the known world for the Greeks. Some historians also believe that Somali societies used to be matriarchal in early centuries before becoming patriarchal. While it's not yet possible to state with certainty that Arawelo existed in history, her story has left a strong impression on Somali culture. Some of Arawelo's maxims are still carried out by Somali women. Wahi ad yeli dantan, di de markohare. Whatever you will accept in the end, you should refuse first. Hudud ragi sugeya. Khalaf kisana kaladora. Unite the strand of men, but always feed them apart. There are many tales in Somali traditions which have similarities with foreign tales, like the cowardly fool, Eyal Shedad, who resembles Mullah Nasruddin, the wise fool in Middle Eastern tales, or Sul, the man that was as small as a thumb, which resembles the tale of Tumbling by the Brothers Grimm. Somali folktales also have some of the traditional monsters and changelings that we encounter in other cultures, like the werewolf, Qoris Miris, who changes into a hyena man by rubbing a wood stick on his body, or the giants, Habidin Akamas and Bririn Abarqo. Somali folktales are a rich tapestry in which is woven the wisdom of centuries past, and they should be preserved as part of our universal story.